Get high with Cloud.
We are back with Sky McCloud. Just got done eating, having margaritas, man. So we're back. As we were stating earlier, lots of things for Sky McCloud coming to the end of this year. We got a couple more months left. But previously, you've been working, sir.
Oh yeah, the grind ain't never gonna stop.
You've been performing, and one of the places that you performed at here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, your hometown, was a Fiserv Forum. Can you please give the fans, the audience, the experience, the process, and how was it for you?
Yeah, so I performed at a business conference for Forever Media. I gotta shout them out because they looked out for me. So they put me on the ticket to perform, and it was at the Fiserv Forum. So that's in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, for those who don't know. That's my hometown. 414. Let's go Bucks. But anywho.
Okay.
But anywho, for the business conference, I rapped and I played my sax. So I did the lunch, and then I did the final set of performances in the actual stadium, the ground floor. So it was electric. Like, you go on my YouTube, not my YouTube, but you go on my TikTok, I kind of show you what the layout is like of being on that ground floor in that stadium. And it was electric. I'm not going to lie to you, it was electric. I felt the energy as soon as I walked through the doors. Because I came out through the tunnel, the same way the ball players come out through. So before I even set up, I went straight through there. They were setting up the stage. I got there bright and early. And I just soaked it all in. So I performed about four rap songs. And then I did a whole saxophone song. So if you ever see my performances, I'm always rapping and I'm always playing the saxophone.
Nice.
I don't want people to confuse that. So I rap and play the saxophone live on stage during the same set. And sometimes during the same song. So rap, couple verses, they go straight to the saxophone to end the song off. So that's my thing. So the best part is the crowd, how the crowd reacted to me. Because it wasn't my crowd, like the tickets were pretty expensive, so my people couldn't really come. They used to pay $10 to $20 to get in versus $100 to $200 to get in. So my people couldn't really come, so I had to win the crowd over that was there. But luckily, during my performance history, I'm used to winning the crowd over.
Man, just hear you talking about it, it seems so surreal. When you talk about how electric it was, and the energy when you walk through, you know, where the ball players walk at, where you came into this stadium. Was it so surreal? Like, was it normal? Was it comfortable for you to be here, to be performing at your hometown, at the Fiserv Forum, 414, where the Milwaukee Bucks play at? You know, how was that process? Like, was this an all-the-way-around exclusive Sky McCloud where he's on stage doing his thing? Was it backup with the other singers? Like, were you the headliner? Like, can you get more in-depth with that?
I wasn't the headliner, which I'm cool with that. I only still got to be the headliner all the time. It was other Milwaukee artists after me. Two Milwaukee artists after me. No, hold on. Let me think. It was one Milwaukee artist after me. So some dancers, me, and then B Justice. Which is cool, because he shut that shit down too. So me, it was just me and the DJ that they already had, which is cool. Cause before I perform, I'm arranging all of my performance music. I'm arranging my own sets 9 times out of 10. Like I said, like being a music producer helps me out a lot. Cause I got all the files to everything. So I can cut it, I can add something, I can take something out, whatever, I can put it all together. So I met up with the DJ hours before my performance, gave him my stuff. Really cool dude. And we got straight to it. I made sure that I met the sound engineer probably 5 or 10 minutes before I got on stage.
So you did a sound check before you
I didn't. I didn't do any sound check.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I didn't do any sound check. So I just gave him my my receiver to my instrument, because the mic was already sounding crispy anyway. So that's one thing I can say. Like, if you ever have an opportunity to perform in a stadium, the sound equipment is already top notch. So this ain't going to no club. This ain't going to no lounge. This ain't going to no bar. This ain't no backyard party shit.
Right.
This is high end shit. So I wouldn't even really too much worried about that. I was more worried about the stage setup.
So you were comfortable. This is you were comfortable doing this.
This is probably the most comfortable I've ever been performing.
Okay.
In my city. Because I knew the quality that was already there.
Correct.
A lot of times when you're an independent artist, you get put into a lot of uncomfortable situations. So unless you get to a certain status to where everything is already hooked up for you. And even then, like, the sound ain't really A1 all the time. So performing in the stadium, the sound was already A1. All I gave him was my receiver to my instrument mic. And I went and did it. And the crowd was receptive.
Nice.
And one of the biggest things that I took out of that moment, besides the fact of performing in the stadium for my first time, is that when another man told me that when I played my saxophone, it made him tear up a little. I don't know if he was gassing me, but I'm just gonna take his word for it. And that was one of the last songs I did, called Sax at Midnight. SAX, not SACKS.
Nice.
Sax.
Right.